Good morning to all of you. This is my second lecture on unit number 1. In this lecture, we will discuss about thermodynamic system surrounding boundary and universe. First of all, we will define the thermodynamic system. The thermodynamic system is defined as the quantity of matter or region in space upon which attention is concentrated for study. So, a system can be represented like this. The size of a thermodynamic system has no limit. It could be as small as nucleus of an atom or as large as Earth or solar galaxy. There is no criteria of shape for system. Here for the schematic diagram, we can represent as any shape. Okay. So this is all about the thermodynamic system. What do we have the surrounding? Surrounding everything external to the system is called surrounding. So if you consider this as a system, everything external to this is called as a surrounding. Now we'll define the boundary. The system and surrounding is separated by the system boundary. So this system and surrounding is separated by this boundary. This surface that separates the system and surrounding is called as a boundary. So the boundary may be real or imaginary. Okay. The boundary may be rigid. That is, for example, just like a wall, it is rigid. Or it could be the moving type of the boundary. For example, balloon. The balloon boundary is flexible. That is moving, or piston inside the cylinder. So piston boundary will be moving. So depending upon the pressure inside the cylinder, the boundary will be moving. Then what do you mean by the universe? A system and its surrounding together is called the universe. Now we'll consider we've learned the types of the thermodynamic system. So first type is the closed system. It is a thermosystem of fixed mass. There is no mass transfer across the system boundary. There may be energy transfer into or out of the system. So if you consider this as a system, so there is no mass interaction or mass exchange between the system and the surrounding, but there may be energy in or energy out. Means energy exchange is possible in closed system. So for example, a certain quantity of fluid, that could be the gas or liquid, in a cylinder bounded by a piston is called as a closed system. Open system is one in which mass can transfer or process the boundary of the system. There may be energy transfer also. So if you consider this as the open system, so mass will be entering into the system, mass will be going to the out of the system. So energy, there may be energy in or energy out. So example of this is air compressor, boiler, turbine, or open room can be considered as a open system. Here the air compressor is considered as a open system because the atmospheric air that is entering into the air compressor across this boundary, and after compression of this air, it will be going out of the thermodynamic system. So this becomes as an example of open system. And third type of thermodynamic system is isolated system. It is a system wherein neither mass nor energy transfer across the system and boundary. So there is no exchange of mass or energy between the system and the surrounding. So this is the example that is a thermos flask. So this is not exact example of isolated system because there is a small energy transfer occurs between the system and surrounding. But approximately we can consider this as a isolated system. Okay. Thank you.